Enthusiastically support their team, recognize outstanding performance of opponents, and always exhibit good sportsmanship in their words and actions. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Varsity Field for today's contest between the Talladega College Tornadoes and your University of Montevallo Falcons. Please welcome tonight's stars, beginning with the visiting Tornadoes. Number one, Arnesia Glenn. Number 2, Michaela Green. Number 4, Taylor Grant. Number 5, Nina Shaw. Number 6, Shakima Jones. Number 7, Lucy Ellen Cordero. Number 10, Zaria Humphrey. Number 11, Onshanae Clark. Number 16, Chantel Collins. Number 20, Jamila Brooks. And number 21, Vania Moreno Miguel. Today, the college is coached by Vince Gatlin.
And now, let's meet tonight's starters for your Montebello Falcons. A sophomore goalkeeper from Barcelona, Spain, number 1, Judith Perez Bayon. A junior forward from Tallahassee, Florida, number 2, Simone Nelson. A freshman midfielder from Clarksville, Tennessee, number 6, Christian Chance. A senior midfielder from Overland Park, Kansas, number 11, Tyler Gonzalez. A senior defender from Madison, Mississippi, number 12, Sarah Daniels. A junior midfielder from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, number 17, Sabrina Amador. A junior defender from Melbourne, Florida, number 19, Rachel Jenkins. A sophomore defender from Huntsville, Alabama, number 22, Madison Madewell. A junior defender from Montgomery, Alabama, number 24, Hampton Brinson. A senior midfielder from Gaston, Alabama, number 28, M.J. Gray. And a junior defender from Louisville, Texas, number 29, Taylor Garrison. Montevallo is coached by Robert Lane with assistant coach Jake Wyman. Ladies and gentlemen, please join us as we honor the United States of America with the playing of our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Varsity Field for the last time this season as Montevallo prepares to take on Talladega College in a Tuesday night battle from Varsity Field. I'm Alex Tejada joining you with the Falcon Athletic Network as we get set to kick off Montevallo, the 7-5-1 side, taking on the Tornadoes who come in here today 1-8. They are 0-7 on their travels, have won once all season, a 3-2 victory over Oakwood. Collins, Brooks and Cordiero had the goals on that occasion, and that brings us to the starting lineups. Arnisha Glenn starts in goal for the visitors. Back line, Michaela Green, Taylor Grant, Chiquina Jones, the aforementioned Chantel Collins, who got that goal in that win, Vonshanae Clark and Zaria Humphrey, a defensive-minded lineup today. In the midfield, Cordiero, who had the winning goal in that game against Oakwood, Nina Shaw and Moreno Heel, and up top by herself, Jamila Brooks, who also scored in that victory. For the Falcons, several changes, and five of the seniors that were honored before Sunday's senior night game get starts today, as does a player who hasn't gotten to start all season, interesting junior Rachel Jenkins, who transferred, comes from Melbourne, Florida. She's starting in the midfield today. In goal is Judith Perez Bayon, who's getting her second start of the season, appearing in her fifth contest. Kristen Chance, Taylor Gonzalez, Sarah Daniels, Simone Nelson, Sabrina Amador, Madison Madewell, Hampton Brinson, MJ Gray, Taylor Garrison make up the rest of the starting lineup. Simone Nelson will be the main target player up front. She scored last season and has an assist to her name this year. Hampton Brinson can play in a variety of positions. She'll start as right back. The Falcons going with the two of Daniels and Garrison at the back, Madewell playing her natural position at left back. Rachel Jenkins and Sabrina Amador will work as defensive midfielders. MJ Gray, Kristen Chance, and Taylor Gonzalez in the midfield will support the junior from Tallahassee, Simone Nelson, and we're underway from Varsity Field. First touch of the game for Rachel Jenkins. She's playing slightly deeper, and Taylor Garrison's moved up to the offensive midfield position. A decent couple of seasons for Talladega College. They've picked up 6 wins in the last 2 years and went 7-8 in 2013. 4-0 at home in their first 2 seasons of being a club. They've had a difficult start to this year. Lost by double digits in 4 games this season, including losses to Alabama A&M, Birmingham Southern, and Faulkner in a 13-0 massacre. Falcons took down Faulkner 4-3 for their first victory of the season. Kira Bockard and Tyler Ring had an incredible second half to cap off a comeback, which they trailed 3-1 at one point. Kristen Chance trying to get the Falcons on the board early on has a shot, and it's just wide left. It would have been her third of the season. She had a good spell of games in which she scored 2-2, looking to get back on the scoreboard today. Another player that will hope to get on the scoreboard in her final game in an illustrious career here at Varsity Field is senior Taylor Gonzalez, scored the game winner against Union 2 weeks ago. Only time she's gotten on the score sheet this season, but she's tied for the most assists on the team with Christian Malone with 3, and has a chance to add to that today against lesser opposition. And of course, this is a chance for Montevallo to build confidence heading into a tough stretch of road games. They take on Mississippi College this Friday before a crucial clash against Delta State, and then the season finale on the 26th against Auburn Montgomery. 8 teams make it to the Gulf South Tournament on the women's side, and right now Montevallo sits in that 9th seed just outside West Georgia and West Alabama. Of course, right below them is UAH and AUM. We mentioned that important contest on the final day. They have to beat Delta State, a team that's just about hanging on, as is Union, for hopes of making the Gulf South Tournament, which three teams have already clinched. North Alabama, Mississippi College, and Lee have 28 and 27 points. Lee clinched on Sunday here at Varsity Field with a 3-0 victory. Montevallo hung tight with the Tornadoes throughout, but were undone by two goals in the first half, and it made it difficult for them to chase the game in the second before Summer Lanter added her 10th. Dawkins did a pretty good job of keeping the reigning Gulf South Player of the Year quiet on that occasion. Bright start for the Falcons here today. Tornadoes trying to soak up pressure and build possession themselves, but a misplaced pass by Cordero. It's intercepted by Chance, who's been lively on the ball. Brinson is used to playing as a right winger, making an overlapping run. Daniels is across the clear, and Brinson's still forward, albeit in an offside position. She checks her run, and Simone Nelson runs onto it. Zaria Humphrey forces her into a corner. Nelson works her way out of that. A cross ball is cut out by Chica Jones. Amador runs onto the ball and lays it off. Good stop. Sabrina Amador with a chance, and instead they get in anyway. Second opportunity of asking.
MJ Gray!
And they eventually get it to fall through MJ Gray, and the Falcons are ahead after 4 minutes. A first ever goal in a Falcons uniform for the senior from Gadsden. A lot of the credit has to go to Sabrina Amador, who worked hard in the box and would not let the ball die. Straight from the kickoff, the Falcons have the ball back through Taylor Garrison, spreads it out to Hampton Brinson. And not the start that coach Vince Gatling in his first year would have wanted against a team as formidable as the Falcons. Good exchange of passes between Gray and Gonzalez, which sets the senior away. She's in on goal and has a chance to double the advantage. Squares the pass for Nelson, but it's cut out at the last second. Zaira Humphrey made the last-ditch challenge where the Falcons would have been in for two in the opening five. It was last touched by Nelson, out for a goal kick. Arnisha Glenn, the junior from Atlanta, Georgia, had a difficult time in goal this season behind a very young back line. Humphrey, Clark, Williams, and Shaw, as well as Green, all freshmen in their first season, as is coach Vince Gatling. He's a Florida A&M graduate, has a huge rebuilding program ahead of him. Talladega College Tornadoes, where Sabrina Amador transferred to Montevallo from. So a lot of talent on display, such as here with Cordero, a sophomore from Pernambuco, Brazil, as well as Moreno Hill in the midfield, a junior from Sumter, South Carolina, offer a couple players to build the team around. Coach Gatling will have seen signs of progress in the 3-2 victory against Oakwood, but since then it's been a difficult run of games. Coming into today's contest on the back of a 5-1 loss to Oakwood, who got revenge for that earlier season victory. Loose pass in the midfield for Moreno Hill. They almost put Gonzalez away on the left side. Important goal for Montevallo to settle early on, and for MJ Gray. It's her first in four seasons, and better late than never. She's gotten a couple assists here in her time, but will love to be on the score sheet. We'll be thanking Sabrina Amador for her hard work to set her up. Ball from Cordero intercepted in the midfield by the goal scorer Gray. Amador puts it forward for Nelson, who beats the offside trap. Stumbles over it, but wins. Ball's closed down by Von Chanet Clark. Forces outside to Taylor Gonzalez. Gonzalez, who's an expert one-on-one player, just drifts by Nina Shaw without too much trickery on this occasion. Shaw keeps it alive for Cordero. Catches Garrison up high and passes to Moreno. Heel has runners on the outside of her. Ball for Chantel Collins to chase, and much better for the visitors. Coach Gatling voicing his approval. Kristen Chance. Amador, who's pulled the strings in midfield, operates as a defensive midfielder but can also work as a more attacking threat. With Taylor Garrison holding. MJ Gray kept onside by Clark. Exchanges passes with Gonzalez, and eventually a shot comes in from Taylor Garrison. Cut across it, and it goes wide right. All Montevallo in the opening 8 minutes of this contest. Mentioned today's a game to build confidence for games coming up. Montevallo take on a Mississippi College side, which is 10-2-1 overall and 9-2 in the conference, and has already secured a spot. So they'll have to balance facing tough opposition with needs first, because they face a game 2 days later against Delta State. Team that's only 4-10 overall, but has 9 conference points with a 3-8 record. Just about feel like they're still in the mix. And on the final day, on the 26th, exactly 9 days from today, Falcons will travel to Montgomery to play AUM, another team which has joined the Gulf South this season, building a rivalry which will probably last for many seasons, as the teams only about an hour in distance. Auburn-Montgomery have 12 points compared to Montevallo's 16. Falcons have 5 conference wins and a draw. AUM were 4-6. Simone Nelson's open. And the keeper comes out, and it's an empty net for Nelson to pass the ball into, and Montevallo have the second goal.
Nelson.
Nothing more than they deserve, and the build-up play was fantastic. Marvelous touch by Simone Nelson to put her around the keeper. And once Glenn opened up the goal, it was a tap-in for the junior. Just the start Coach Lane would have liked to see, and he's giving his team signs of approval. Positive start. They've moved the ball around well. Substitution for the Falcons as well. Cordero, kept alive by Taylor Grant, one of the few upperclassmen in this side. Amador. Brinson keeps it alive on the outside. Tried to catch Chance and Nelson on the right side of the line, and while they did manage to hold their runs, Michaela Green got there first, but Montevallo have the ball in an attacking position yet again. Montevallo trying to keep possession in the midfield. Saw the Falcons play a game in which they were heavily favored against Albany State, and they labored to a 2-0 victory. Today they've raced out to a 2-goal lead, and it seems that Coach Lane prefers to see the skill of his side and the patience in the buildup. Also several subs he'll want to bring off the bench. The Tornadoes hold an extremely high line, all of their players in Montevallo's half, of course. No offside if you're in your own half. So Simone Nelson, check her runs. She can be through on goal with 50 yards to run into. Go back to Perez Bayon. Everyone getting a touch on the ball in this possession for the Falcons. Coach Lane and Wyman stress the importance of a patient build-up play with many passes. Trying to string some beautiful soccer together here. Madewell. Crossfield ball to her center back, Daniels. Amador did well to hold her run and does have the 50 yards of space to run into, but Zaria Humphrey will get there and just put off the junior. Amador has two goals this season to go along with an assist and scored the winner against Shorter. Chance from distance for Gray, and it's caught on this occasion by Arnisha Glenn. It was well up to the task, read it the whole way. It was a decent strike from Gray. Gray has been an important part of this side for several seasons, started more in her freshman and sophomore seasons when it was a much thinner squad, and even with all the newcomers brought in by Coach Lane, she's managed to retain her spot. She's had to come up off the bench. It had several important contributions last year, including a major assist in the 6-win season this year. Montevallo continue to build and look to get an 8th win tonight. The win against Shorter was a 7th and already secured the winningest season Coach Lane's 3-year tenure. A win today will put them a long way to going to a first winning season since 2009. Falcons will only need to win one of the remaining 4 contests to secure a winning campaign. They will have goals, however, set on reaching the Gulf South tournament and making a splash in their first season since returning from the Peach Belt. 5-5-1 in the Gulf South faced some difficult defeats that were kind of hard to take, especially the 1-0 against North Alabama. A top 25 ranked team came in here and had a difficult time as Simone Nelson slots in another.
Goal!
A wry smile from the junior as she adds her 2nd. And the forward from Tallahassee has a brace inside 15 minutes and is on her way to a hat trick. Simone Nelson adding her 3rd of the year. And a substitution for the visitors. Taylor Grant being brought off. Easy afternoon so far for Rachel Jenkins, who picks up a ball at the back and tries to spread it forward for Nelson, who will be looking for that 3rd. Moreno Gill. And it's kept alive on the far side by Chantel Collins. Tries to play a ball in the box and wins a corner kick. Set piece opportunity for the Tornadoes, who have been pushed back by Montevallo's pressure, have held a high line, but have got caught out on the last occasion by some runs in behind. Past 2 goals have been from Simone Nelson after MJ Gray opened the scoring inside 5 minutes. Chance here from a corner. Dummy by Clark almost set it through for Moreno Heel. Clark, lovely footwork on the outside, dancing around Collins. Has runners in the support of the goal scorers Gray and Nelson, but instead checks back to Taylor Garrison. Garrison plays through Gray, and it's 2-on-1 for the Falcons. Gray backs her speed, runs in on goal, waits for Madison Madewell to arrive, and unselfishly lays it off to the sophomore from Huntsville. Plays the ball back to Amador. Garrison. Chance goes all the way back to Jenkins. Back through Amador, and MJ Gray's in tons of space, splits the center backs. Good possession by the Falcons. Made well in space on this left side. Mentioned Montevallo's season concludes on the 26th against AUM. They're the team that are sitting in the 10th position. We'll be fighting along with the Falcons for that final 8th spot, hoping to dethrone West Alabama or West Georgia. The Warhawks are 5-8, 4-6. Had a 3-win streak in the middle of the season against Spring Hill, West Alabama, and UAH. However, after that, suffered 4 consecutive losses: Christian Brothers, Union, Valdosta State, and Lee. After those 4 losses, they managed to salvage things on Sunday with a 3-0 victory at home against Shorter. Just about keeps them in touch with the teams above them. A big game this Friday against Delta State. You would imagine the winner of that will be challenging for that 8th and final spot along with the Falcons. Of course, they play Mississippi College as well this weekend. They conclude the season with a trip to West Florida, a makeup game due to inclement weather, for ending the year on Senior Day against Albany State, a team which Montevallo beat 2-0 earlier this season. Goals from Amador and Darnell on that occasion. Zaria Humphrey gets play resumed. Cordero shows strength to hold off MJ Gray. Closed down by Garrison, spreads it out to Nina Shaw. Moreno Heel almost laid it off into the path of an on-rushing attacker. Difficult opening 17 minutes for the Tornadoes. A comfortable Montevallo preparing 5 substitutes. Coach Lane looking to see the depth in his squad heading in front of these final 3 matches of the season. Falcons hoping that 2 out of 3 will be enough to carry them to the GSC tournament. Not sure anybody's liking their odds in traveling to Clinton, Mississippi, and picking up a win against the Choctaws. The Falcons will expect to win their final 2 games, albeit road contests at Delta State and Auburn Montgomery. Falcons opened up last season with a 3-1 win against Delta State. Falcons will hope to catch Delta State deflated if they lose to AUM. Also make AUM a lot better opposition for them to beat on the final day. Amador pulls it down in the midfield, closed down by Shaw. Garrison comes away with possession. Falcon sub still waiting to come on. Madewell plays the ball through, but Gray can't beat the offside trap. Tornadoes holding an extremely high line on the edge of midfield. 20 minutes in, Montevallo 3-0 in front, thanks to goals from MJ Gray and a brace from Simone Nelson. It's a very straightforward game for the Falcons in what has not been a straightforward season. They tried an attempt to open the year up on the 31st on August, but we only saw 30 minutes of play before play was suspended due to lightning in the area. Since the game did not reach the 70th minute, The game was replayed in its entirety, but not before the Falcons had lost their opening away game of the year, a 3-1 loss to Valdosta State, where Allie Darnell, the freshman, scored her first goal in her first game. Missed a penalty late on with a chance to tie it at 2-2 in an eventful debut for the Falcons. Taylor Snell and the Bulldogs added a third late on. What was not a very accurate scoreline, the Falcons could have at least drawn that contest in Georgia that night. After that, looked like things have gone from bad to worse when they were down 3-1 to Faulkner, a team that surprisingly beat them 1-0. And in that makeup game that was played in Montgomery rather than Montebello, a second-half comeback by Tyler Ring and Kira Bockard, two goals each, saw them 4-3 winners. They carried that momentum into a 2-1 win over West Georgia. Bockard again on the score sheet, as well as fellow freshman Hannah Waukee, who will probably see some time in this contest. She's been a revelation on the wing since arriving from Long Beach, California. Despite losing Taylor Gonzalez next season, Coach Lane will feel he has replaced the senior from Overland Park, Kansas, with Bockard and Waukee. Falcons had a hard loss to take, and a 1-0 narrow loss to North Alabama, which was decided by a controversial late free kick. Falcons then took down Albany State 2-0. Kristen Chance got her first goal before Darnell added another to her tally. Against Spring Hill, the Falcons were the strongest side in the first half, but Michaela Franklin's goal saw them pegged back with a goal on a free kick before Tyler Ring scored with the final kick of the first half to put them up 2-1 at the break. Kristen Chance's second in two games and Sabrina Amador's first of the year helped them coast to a 4-1 victory. It was an up-and-down way of ending September for the Falcons as they took down UAH, a double in the first half for Darnell. But then they were on the wrong end of that scoreline against West Alabama. Beat Union on the 6th earlier this month. Taylor Gonzalez had the winner in the second half before drawing Christian Brothers. After trailing 2-0, Michaela Franklin and Allie Darnell salvaged a point on the road. The Falcons then had a makeup game in Pensacola, which they lost 1-0 to Kryles. Lone strike. Then they got things back on track on Friday with a 1-0 victory against Shorter and are looking to bounce back from Sunday's Senior Day defeat to Lee, a 3-0 loss, which saw the Flames clinch the third seed in the GSC tournament. North Alabama and Mississippi College, the other two sides to have secured their returns to the GSC tournament, which will take place in Montgomery at the end of this month. Falcons currently on 16 points. Above them are West Alabama and West Georgia, who are both on 18 with 6 conference wins. Christian Brothers is slightly ahead of them with 19. Then Valdosta State and West Florida will feel fairly confident of clinching the 4th and 5th spots. But between Christian Brothers, West Alabama, West Georgia, Montebello, AUM, UAH, Union, and Delta State, there are 3 more spots up for grabs. And 8 teams going for it, so lots of actions to be played left in the game, despite only 3 contests left for the Falcons. Substitutes still waiting to come on. A lot of good passing in the midfield. MJ Gray being put under Chiquina Jones, and now the Falcons can make their changes. Gray, Madewell, Nelson, Garrison, and Kristen Chance, as well as Sabrina Amador, making way. Keller Mackimson coming in at the back. Join Rachel Jenkins. Alex Zagara is also seeing her second action of the year, as is
for the Falcons, Valerie Zagara,
Emily Blue checks in at defensive midfield. Freshman from Spanish Fort, Alabama, Rachel Smith is also seeing her first action in the midfield today. Val Visaggio, who's featured as a sub on several occasions, is back into the game. MJ Gray is pushed further up front. And Jada Johnson is being brought on, playing out wide right. One back well by Keller Mackinson, freshman from Nashville, Tennessee. So several important pieces for the Falcons in the coming years, with six seniors graduating. Visaggio. Visaggio's deep sitting position will allow Emily Blue to play more of an attacking midfielder, naturally a defensive midfielder, but will have license to go forward. Good ball over the top for Rachel Smith to run onto. Lays it off to MJ Gray. She's done well pulling the strings in the center of the park. Emily Blue plays through Jada Johnson. It's forced outside by Michaela Green. Short to Blue, who's from nearby Pelham, Alabama. Junior, who's also joined on the team by her sister Elizabeth, who was recognized on senior night and has featured in the contest this year as well. Emily lays it off. Good exchange of passes. Visaggio spreads it out wide to Rachel Smith. Segura. Jenkins out to Jada Johnson. .17 to go until the break. Montevallo got out to a 3-0 lead courtesy of a brace from Simone Nelson and the opener from MJ Gray, who's holding a good line here. Wasn't seen by Val Visaggio. Spreads it out wide to Jenkins. Lovely weighted ball for Jada Johnson to run onto, but equally good defending by Michaela Green to close her down. Johnson continues the fight and allows Visaggio to step in and win the ball back. Visaggio to Zagara. Visaggio formed an important partnership last year with Vic Whitehouse. Whitehouse, Amador, Lino have been preferred to her this season. She's made important contributions coming off the bench. This is her sixth game this year. It shows the depth in the defensive mid position that the Falcons have, as well as in the attack. Thing Coach Lane's trying to sort out is the backup defense. Now the Falcons have seen several different formations at the back and are working out new defenders right now. Zagara is playing left back. Probably sees Kukis and Madewell play that position ahead of her, but the Falcons hope to see some defensive options going forward, with Garrison graduating and Sarah Daniels graduating. Christian Malone is their only center back, and perhaps they could find a new one tonight with Jenkins and Mackinson. Good shot turned aside by Glenn, or Gray would have had a second. Rachel Smith picks up the loose pieces. What a moment it would be for one of the freshmen to grab a goal here tonight. Do a lot for their confidence moving forward. Perhaps make a case for a starting position. Here's MJ Gray with a chance to make it two on the night, and she hits the crossbar. The Falcons are 2 inches away from 4-0. Moreno Heel spreads it out, and a chance to break for the Tornadoes. Try to do so at pace, but the Falcons bring back players such as Emily Blue, who forces a mistake, and Rachel Jenkins intervenes. Here's Blue on the ball again. Inch perfect pass for Visaggio. Visaggio Gray plays it forward for Blue. positive signs for Coach Lane's team in the passing. It's like a training session out here, just triangle, passing, pass and move. His philosophy put into practice and in full display here tonight. Segarra, return ball from Visaggio. Under pressure from Von Chanet Clark. Jada Johnson holds off a defender and is through on goal if she can get on the other side of Shaw. Keeps it alive through Blue. Visaggio, who's sitting at that focal point of midfield, making sure nobody gets forward. Also has the vision. Pick out the wingers. She has a distance shot from all of 30 yards out. Plucked out of the air by Arnisha Green. It looked to be traveling. Glenn read it well. Couldn't match it with a distribution, and it goes out of bounds. Intended for Vania Moreno Hill. Gray dropping deeper into midfield, leaving Rachel Smith the farthest player forward. Visaggio. Segarra steps out from pressure. Nina Shaw, the player forcing her inroads. Emily Blue, who's looked positive on the ball since her introduction. Perez Bayon. Perez Bayon has one start in the game against Albany State. This is her second of the season, hoping to keep two shutouts in two games. Saw action at the beginning of last year before being replaced by Ellie Muyal. Lost out in the competition this season to Sydney Young, who has three shutouts and 12 starts to go along with 58 saves. Be interesting to see with Young's injury problems this year. Perez Bayon proving to be a solid backup. How Coach Lane treats the keeper position moving forward. We've seen in the past he plays one keeper one half and another. And with both players going to be juniors next season, be a fierce competition in the offseason for the starting spot between the pipes. Rachel Smith reaches contact on a half volley straight at Arnisha Glenn. Smith, one of those freshmen hoping to open their account for the Falcons here tonight. Rachel Jenkins. Pass is intercepted by Cordero, who's looked the brightest player in the midfield for the Tornadoes. They have pace and width through Chantel Collins, who gallops forward. Has Moreno heel in the box, tries to cross it to her, and a first good stop from Perez Bayon. Didn't allow the follow-up from Collins, but concedes a second corner. It's a low delivery on the first occasion. Hoping for a better delivery this time around from Chantel Collins. Last time she looked for Von Chanet Clark and it was cut out. Cordero offers a short option. Emily Blue is in defense. Nina Shaw on the far post being covered by Visaggio. A late arrival by Zaria Humphrey, watched by Smith. Instead, they go short to Cordero. Freshman LaVita Williams, a forward from Chicago, Illinois, is checked in for the visitors. As he tries something different up front to try to get another shot on Perez Bayon's goal. Can't control it. On this occasion, it's Chantel Collins. Despite only one win this season, they've won 13 in their past 3 years. So not a completely new program. Coach Vince Gatling is taking over. But with such a small roster and so many young players, he will feel this will be a rebuilding program. Pass to Jada Johnson from Rachel Smith catches freshman from Clarksville, Tennessee, offside. Robert Lane took over a program that only won one game before he took charge. Only won two in his first season. His first home victory here at Varsity Field was a dramatic overtime win over Christian Brothers. Abby West had the lone goal. Last year, his second season saw much improvement. The Falcons ended with six wins on the year and made it to the Peach Belt Conference Tournament in their final season. Finished the year 6-9-1, 5-6-1 in the Peach Belt. And were knocked out by nationally ranked Columbus State. They won their final Peach Belt home game as well as their final Peach Belt game overall. They won on the final day against USC Aiken and had a dramatic 4-2 win against Lander on senior night a year ago. Tyler Ring, who has three goals this year, led the team last season with six assists. He's had more license to go forward at right wing this year. Getting a rest today, but the sophomore from North Carolina will be instrumental going forward for the Falcons trying to secure postseason berths. Taylor Gonzalez has one goal this year, scored eight last season. Michaela Franklin, who has two this year, had four a season ago. Has had injury troubles, but looks to be back to full health. Eight to go before the break. Falcons keeping their foot not firmly pressed on the gas pedal after a frantic opening 10 minutes. Saw them put three up on the Tornadoes. Two from Simone Nelson as well as one from this midfielder here, MJ Graves, playing in her final game at home. What has been a successful career for the senior from Gadsden. Paris Bayon. Distribution is too strong for Val Visaggio. Intercepted. Jones is dispossessed by Gray, who's been all over the park tonight. Zagara. Falcons utilizing width, which they haven't gone to in the past 10 or so odd minutes. Gray. Saggio. Falcons playing a very extended game of keep away in the past 20 minutes. Slowly lulling the opposition to sleep and trying to put through a final incisive pass. This time Jada Johnson holds her run. It's beat to it by Zaria Humphrey. Looked as if Jada Johnson may have been a shade offside, but the linesman kept his flag down and Zaria Humphrey did well to not allow any space for Johnson. Freshman from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. One of the players, as is LaVita Williams, another freshman who's come on. Coach Gatling hopes to build a side around. He will also have Moreno Heel and Cordero, arguably the season's MVPs for the Tornadoes, back again next year. Rachel Smith. Visaggio crosses the ball. Switches play to Johnson. Right now, inch-perfect passing from the Falcons. Trying to perfect the movement in the midfield today. They will have a lot less space when they take on Gulf South opposition in the next week. Trying to make it perfect. Falcons had very little time in which to work on the ball on Sunday against Lee, but were unlucky to go down 2-0 at the break. It was an even first half. Conceded a goal 2 minutes before halftime. In the second half, they chased, leaving open spaces at the back, allowed Summer Lanter her 10th of the year. Ball for Emily Blue to run onto, but Zaria Humphrey beats her on this occasion. Blue does well to poke it away. Rachel Smith, overlapping run by Zagara from left back. Cut out quickly by Von Shanae Clark. Montevallo with most of the possession here today. Gotten many shots off this year. The problem has been converting chances. Despite 50% of their shots being shots on goal, only scoring on 9% of their shots. Averaging 15 shots a game. Have 19 goals for, but have conceded 17. And a good effort from distance for Visaggio, looking her first of the campaign. It's just high. 3 minutes to go until the break. Falcons have also conceded 2 penalties this year. Have 5 yellow cards to go along with 1 red card in the opening game of the season. Since then, have looked a much more disciplined side. Have 15 assists on the year. Gotten many players involved. Setting up goals. Christian Malone and Taylor Gonzalez lead the side with 3 apiece. And a very even corner count throughout the season. Coach Lane and Wyman have worked on set pieces heavily in the offseason. The Falcons looked more deadly from corner kicks, but will lose their corner taker, Taylor Gonzalez, next season. You mentioned Hannah Walkie and Kira Bockard. Look to be solid replacements at the left midfield position, which Gonzalez has occupied for the last 4 years. But replacing 2016's leading goal scorer, who had 8 a season ago, won't be the easiest of tasks. But Waki has already proved to be effective going forward, has a goal and 2 assists in her 10 games started. Bockard has 3 goals but hasn't scored since September. Allie Darnell, a freshman from Graves County, Kentucky, has won Freshman of the Year honors 2 times this year. Has been the real revelation. 5 goals and 2 assists. Falcons will hope to rely on their talisman forward in the final 3 games, hoping to secure one of the top 8 spots in the Gulf South tournament, which will take place at the end of this month in Montgomery. Rachel Smith, the midfielder from Spanish Ford, on the ball. Forced back by Shaw, finds Visaggio. The Falcons' passing percentage has to be near 90%, if not 100, in this opening half. Such has been the crispness of their attacks and the space allowed by Talladega. 60 seconds to go till the half. Sending numbers forward for a last attack. Chantel Collins running, pursued by Keller Mackemson. Freshman from Nashville does well. Wins a throw-in for her side. Showed good strength in only her 2nd appearance of the year. Crucial minutes in which to gain experience. Practice always helps. There's nothing that can simulate a game day experience. And several young freshmen getting their first taste of full-time action here tonight. 10, 9, Montevallo 8, could be criticized for 7, an easy 6, non-conference 5, schedule, but with such a competitive 4, Gulf South 3, schedule, 2, they have used 1. Their non-conference games well to boost confidence. Haven't lost a conference game this year, a non-conference game, knocking off both Faulkner and Albany State. Today only their 3rd non-conference game of the season. Conference which got even tougher with the addition of Auburn, Montgomery, and Montevallo, both teams trying to make the Gulf South tournament. in their first season. AUM and NAIA side, the Falcons moving from the Peach Belt, making a good showing this year. And at the break, 3-0 Montevallo. Simone Nelson's first half brace puts the Falcons with a comfortable lead after things got started by senior MJ Gray scoring in her final home game. We'll be back for the second half from Varsity Field. Thank you for watching the Falcon Athletic Network. I'm Alex Tata. Welcome back to Varsity Field for the final 25 minutes of the season. That's not a mistake. You were looking at 25 minutes left in the game. The shortened 45-minute half, Montebello have dominated the proceedings 3-0. Got started in the fifth minute. MJ Gray was put through after Sabrina Amador's shot was saved by Arnisha Glenn. Falcons had a second on 10 minutes through Simone Nelson, who was unassisted. She was put through by Kristen Chance in the 14th to add a third. And since then, it's been easy going for the Falcons. Two shots on goal for the visitors by Chantel Collins, who looked the brightest player on the side on that left wing. Montevallo had 11 shots and brought in six substitutes, including two players making their season debuts, Emily Blue and Rachel Smith, who had a shot on goal in the first half. Seven of those for the Falcons compared to none for Talladega. However, the only two corner kicks of the opening period went to the Tornadoes. Montevallo also committed the only foul. Four saves for Arnisha Glenn in goal. Zero for Judith Perez-Bayon, who's been untested. Falcons starting with a similar lineup that they opened with, except for Jada Johnson and Emily Blue keep their positions. Open Rachel Smith, who does well to collect and has space to run into. Only Jada Johnson on the far post. Holds back. Good cross for Simone Nelson, who will be looking for her hat trick. Nelson has it on her right foot and shoots, and she fires it. Fires it to the bottom corner. And finds the hat trick less than 2 minutes into the second half. Only had two goals for the Falcons before today. Has added three to her account tonight. And three of the simplest goals the junior will ever score. The great turn on the edge of the area that put her in, worked it onto the right foot, and buried it into the right corner. Glenn has been replaced in goal this half by Vania Moreno-Hill. She could not prevent the junior from scoring her first hat trick, the first hat trick of the season for Robert Lane's side. Mentioned today was a confidence booster, so a real morale increase for Simone Nelson and this team, which has been led by Allie Darnell's five goals, not being risked tonight. Rachel Smith has made a bright start to life as a Falcon in her first appearance. Wins a corner kick off of Zaria Humphrey. Recorded her first contribution on that last goal, assisted Simone Nelson for her third. See how long it is before Coach Lane makes more changes. Will he allow Simone Nelson to add some more goals? Another corner kick. Taylor Garrison was the closest in attendance. Shot was blocked. Smith will have another effort to end swing it. Mackemson has also stayed in the game, as has Zagara. Good delivery by Smith, but it goes out for another corner kick. Defended at the near post. Nelson on the keeper. MJ Gray making a late run. Bounces in the direction of Nelson, who keeps it alive. Gray works a bit of space inside the box, leaves it for Jada Johnson, sizes it up on her right foot, takes a shot, a lot of deflection. It goes off the crossbar, almost falls on the rebound for Nelson, collects it at the second time of asking. Smith with another chance to return it in the box. MJ Gray has it tackled away, looking for a second. Hit the crossbar herself earlier in the first half. Johnson hoping to get her first goal of the year. Good delivery in the box. Met first time by MJ Gray. Gray's effort just wide of the goal. Montevallo in the first 5 minutes of the second half on the front foot, as they were the majority of the first half. Smith. Good cross, forcing a clearance. And another corner kick. Coach Wyman applauding the freshman. It's been a marvelous opportunity for the young faces to cut their teeth early on. A chance for the goalkeeper, loses it on this cross. Chantel Collins, a quick clearance, but it goes as far as Jada Johnson, kept off the line. Collins with another hat clear. Zaria Humphrey, under pressure by Gray, forces it forward for Grant. Won back well by Rachel Smith, who's having an excellent game. Garrison. Mackemson out to Rachel Jenkins. Mackemson sells Garrison short, but she does well to win it back and finds fellow senior MJ Gray. Ball over the top for Johnson. Not allowed enough space to turn by Michaela Green. Drifts comfortably back for Jamila Brooks, who's gone in goal in place of Arnisha Glenn in the second half. Taylor Grant, the only striker. Johnson in acres of space on the right side, swings the ball. Nelson looking for a fourth. Nelson cuts inside, as an effort, just high right. An onslaught of Falcons pressure in the last 5 minutes. Not resting on their laurels at 4-0. But a team that has suffered 13 and 12-0 losses this year, doesn't appear that Montevallo is the side to run up the score, perhaps. But a sportsmanship on the part of Coach Lane, perhaps just wanting to see his team play quality soccer rather than just send numbers forward and long ball chase it. So good play. And good sportsmanship by Coach Lane and Wyman. Would be tempting to try to reach 20 odd goals or try to break some school records here today, but instead, utilizing young players, teaching them to play the right way, the Falcons moving the ball around very admirably. MJ Gray with a lovely outside of the football to Rachel Smith. The Falcons move the ball around so well in the first half, or moving it around equally as well, but at a slightly higher tempo. Mentioned the Falcons will not be afforded this kind of space in their upcoming games. They conclude the season 3 road trips, 2 of which are in Mississippi this weekend as they take on the Mississippi College Choctaws before a crucial clash against Delta State Statesmen. Of course, on Friday, the Statesmen will take on AUM, who Montevallo faced in the last game of the season. Montevallo, AUM, UAH, Union, and Delta State, all teams looking on the outside, hoping to replace either West Alabama or West Georgia, who occupy the final 2 spots for the Gulf South Tournament. 3 spots have already been clinched: North Alabama, Mississippi College, and Lee. Valdosta State and West Florida look all but guaranteed to clinch positions as well. Which leaves 3 spots open. Christian Brothers have a slight advantage over West Alabama and West Georgia with 19 points compared to the 18. Montevallo sit at 16, just 2 off of that 8th spot. Auburn, Montgomery, and UAH, as well as Union, have 12, and Delta State just about hanging on with 9 points before Shorter and Spring Hill bring up the foot of the table, haven't managed a result in conference all year, and are 0-20 between those 2 sides. Coach Lane figuring out about his depth today. Trying to bring home an 8th victory if they win 1 of their final few matches. They will guarantee a winning result, advancing to 8-5-1 tonight. See them with a chance of reaching 10 wins. Most importantly, they'll be looking for that 8th seed in the tournament in Montgomery later this month. They have a difficult task ahead of them on Friday. Take on a team that last year won in the semifinals against Lee in penalty kicks before advancing to the tournament, taking home the GSC tournament crown. West Florida, the only team to outdo them. So they took down West Georgia in the Gulf South quarterfinals. West Georgia hoping to return to that spot. AUM and Montevallo hoping to keep them out. West Georgia fell to the Falcons 2-1 earlier this year. Entertaining clash. Saw Bockert and Waukee get the goals. It could prove very important, as could be the 2-0 loss to West Alabama, a result that puts them ahead of the Falcons in the Gulf South ahead of the final three games. After the meeting against the 10-2-1 Choctaws, Falcons travel to 4-10 Delta State and will earmark that as the game to propel them into AUM on a high note. Mentioned that game could be a play-in to that eighth and final spot. Both sides sit just outside looking in to the final two spots in the conference. Learning a lot about their depth tonight. Rachel Smith has had a bright introduction, as has Emily Blue. Smith's afternoon is over as Zagara has replaced her, and Zagara's through on goal looking for her first. Jada Johnson smashes it across the box and is a few feet wide of the left post. 13 to go in the contest in a 25-minute second half. Falcons up 4-0, and MJ Gray trots off the field. What will be her final time playing in front of Varsity Field. The senior from Gadsden, Alabama, has had a great career. Could be proud of her performance today. She got the scoring opened, a moment she's been waiting for a long time. So congratulations to MJ Gray on a solid career and a wonderfully taken goal, which will prove to be a game winner if they can keep Talladega College off the board. Across from Jada Johnson, over everyone, including Alex Segarra, and goes out for a goal kick. Been a tough half for Jamila Brooks, but she's managed to only concede once, placing keeper Arnisha Glenn. Perez Bayon, trying to stay warm on the other side of the goal, has been untested throughout this contest, despite two shots from Chantel Collins. Visitors 1-8 took down Oakwood 3-2 before losing to them 5-1 in their most recent contest. Have three games the rest of the season against Agnes Scott, Georgia Gwinnett, who's number 24, and Judson College, which beat them 10-0 earlier this year, but a team which they beat the season before. A week from tomorrow, everything comes down to the clash in Montgomery at 7 o'clock. Friday and Sunday will go a long way to deciding how important that game is and if Montevallo have a shot at a 10-win season. Most importantly, a GSC tournament berth. Robert Lane finding out which subs may be required in those three contests as a plan B. It's been a bright start to the season. In her first year, Allie Darnell has 5 goals and 2 assists. Tyler Ring has 3 goals, as does Kira Bockard. Franklin, Chance, and Amador also have a pair of goals. Visaggio, who exemplifies how very deep this side is. Long ball over the top for Jada Johnson, who's looking for her first goal. Johnson's featured in 13 contests and has started one. Chooses to be provider. Segarra lays it off, and a shot and a goal. Emily Blue. Adds a fifth for the Falcons in an important moment personally for her. The junior from Pelham in her first appearance of the season has a goal. A well-worked move by Jada Johnson. Good ball down the right channel. Cut back by Alex Segarra, who gets the assist. No mistake. From about 12 yards out, Emily Blue getting congratulations from her teammates. Hug from center back Rachel Jenkins, and it's been a comfortable contest for the Falcons, and now it shows on the scoreboard, 5-0. The largest win of the year. And the first time they've scored five goals. They scored four on two occasions against Faulkner and Spring Hill. Brings Montevallo to 24 goals on the season. They scored 29 the entirety of last year. Only conceded 16. Had 30 conceded last year, so a lot better defense. A lot of credit can go to Christian Malone, the defender from Winnipeg, Canada, who started all but one contest and featured in every game, has three assists as well as helping her team to three shutouts. Falcons only averaged 10 shots a game last year and are averaging 15 this time around, but only managing a 10% shot percentage compared to last year's 17%. Just like last year, 50% of their shots being shots on goal. Host still in search of another goal in the final 10 minutes. Did well playing keep away for large portions of the first half. Perez Bayonne all of 40 yards outside of her goal. As ridiculous as it sounds for a keeper to score, that's exactly what happened on Sunday as Montevallo's Robert Kuta salvaged a late draw against Lee. Unbelievable goal that you could see on our Montevallo Falcons Instagram page. Of course, following this, catch Montevallo versus North Alabama from Trustmark Arena. Just about 100 yards from Varsity Field at 7 o'clock. Good shot from distance. And Simone Nelson looking for more. Has a hat trick. Almost added a fourth. A few feet wide of the left goal. On the Montevallo for You YouTube channel, you can catch that game at 7 o'clock from Trustmark Arena as the 8-10 Falcons look to build some momentum heading into this weekend's three games in 2 days slate that they have that starts with Lee on Friday, the Dick Lavender game against AUM Saturday morning before they conclude a strenuous weekend at 4 on Saturday against Spring Hill. All of those games from Trustmark Arena will also be broadcast on the Montevallo for You YouTube channel. So check that out as soon as this contest finishes. What is becoming a cool afternoon at Varsity Field. We've seen some sweltering Sunday afternoon games. But a great night for soccer here today. And Jada Johnson, a great opportunity to add her first goal. She's in on goal, and Jada Johnson has her goal. First. And the Jada Falcons have a Johnson. Sixth. What a moment that is for the freshman from Clarksville, Tennessee. Featured in all 13 games and is finally on the board. Opens her of Montevallo scoring account. With 7 minutes to play, Falcons stretch the scoreline out. Job done at Varsity Field. Now just a final 7.5 minutes for the fans to enjoy before the Falcons embark on a three-game road trip. A week from tomorrow, we'll know the final Gulf South standings. So stay tuned to MontevalloFalcons.com and GSCSports.org to see if the Falcons will compete on the 28th from the YMCA Fields in Montgomery in the GSC tournaments. Their first time since returning from the Peach Belt. The Falcons got that final seed last year and took on Columbus State in the quarterfinals. Run on the outside by Alex Segarra, and she's caught on the wrong side. defensive play by the Tornadoes. Taylor Grant stepping up, catching her on the wrong side of the line. Sierra Simmons and Nina Shaw also on the same page. Cordero looks bright on the ball, but hasn't seen too much of it in the midfield. Hasn't been any space for her or any numbers forward for her to pass to. Finding Chiquina Jones on this occasion. Unable to put a string of passes together, and the Falcons pour pressure on again. Kristen Chance in a tussle in the midfield. This time she loses out. Shaw. Her run cut short by Mackemson. Well-weighted pass from Visaggio again for Johnson. Shows her strength to skip past Taylor Grant. Gets a return pass, and Johnson's offside. Good save and goal by Jamila Brooks anyway. It's a lovely return ball by Emily Blue, who scored her first goal as well for the fifth goal. So Blue and Jada Johnson with confidence building goals here in the second half. Simone Nelson finished off her hat trick earlier this half as well. Had a brace in the first half, and MJ Gray got things started in the fifth minute, which sees us at 6-0. It's been an easy contest for referee Tiffany Turpin to manage. Nothing too malicious, only one foul all game, which was committed by the Falcons. Jamila Brooks' goal kick is cut out well by Visaggio. Cordero almost dispossesses it, but it breaks for Humphrey, who loses out to Blue. Blue, the junior from Pelham, Alabama. It's her first time playing in this game. She's showing herself as a possible option off the bench for the Falcons' upcoming road trips. Moreno heel. Cordero. Looking for a ball forward. A rare foray for Nikki Shaw in the offensive. Put off by Rachel Jenkins. Mackemson gets it clear, but it's still alive for Moreno heel. Flicks it forward. Jenkins closes her down. Jenkins trying to prevent a corner and does well to do so. Both corner kicks in the first half went way of the Tornadoes, who could make nothing of it. And Talladega looked like a substitution. It's been a difficult afternoon for Coach Gatlin. It's been a difficult year. But the Florida A&M player hopes that he has a rebuilding process in the works and can center it around players such as Nina Shaw, Moreno Heel, as well as Cordero. Collins also looked bright in the first half and had both of her side shots. And a very young back four. She's gained valuable experience, if nothing else. Had a tough schedule as well this season. Rachel Smith back in the contest. Smart play by the freshman. Playing a more defensive role behind Alex Segarra. Keller Mackemson. Ball over the top, and the offside flag is up on this occasion. Alex Segarra this time being flagged. Kristen Chance and Emily Blue were also making runs. Quick restart for Cordero. Referee pulling the play back to be taken from the position of the offside. Nina Shaw getting play back. Moreno heel. Strong tackle to win it away, but it's cleared by Rachel Smith. Can play in defense or midfield, operating as a left back. Falcons blessed with two talented left backs, Taylor Kukas, junior, as well as sophomore Madison Madewell, who can also operate as a defensive midfielder. Samara Lino, Vic Whitehouse, and Sabrina Amador have dominated that position, which has limited to the amount of games Val Visaggio has had, despite her fantastic showing today, which will put her in contention for seeing more action later in the year. A good ball over the top for Jada Johnson, who shows considerable strength to win it back. Came to Montevallo a defensive option, has emerged as a right wing as well as a left midfielder. Hasn't seen too much action at defense, but as a real defensive-minded midfielder, provides pace on the outside as well as good tracking back, being a naturally defensive-minded player. Visaggio switches play to Rachel Smith, another outside midfielder. Naturally is a defender. Zagar will try to chase this and keep it in the touchline. Just about manages to do so. Cuts it back to Rachel Smith. Scuffed cross is met by Emily Blue, who returns it to the freshman. Second opportunity for Smith to swing it in, and it's dropped by the keeper. Simone Nelson was there, but Jamila Brooks got it at the second time of asking. Final 60 seconds from Varsity Field this season. Montevallo have been 6-3 at home this year. And a chance to finish it off on a nice way, and Simone Nelson gets a fourth.
Simone Nelson.
A seventh of the game.
1 minute remaining for the game.
A fourth of this half, and Montevallo advanced to a seventh home win and an eighth of the season. Coach Lane's third year continuing to break personal records, and Montevallo well on their way to a first winning season since 2009. They'll have to pick up a victory on their travels, something that they've only done once. Their only victory on the road was a 1-0 win over Union, but they need at least one win to secure a winning season, two for a double-digit win season, and at least two to make the GSC tournament, it would appear. Tough to those contests is the next one up on Friday against 10-2-1 Mississippi College. The Choctaws have already secured a spot in the GSC tournament and currently sit sixth. But the most competitive matches and the ones Robert Lane will have been circling on the schedule before the season even started. The game against Delta State, who will be looking for revenge in that 3-1 game last year. Game where Anuka Bass leveled after hat-trick hero Simone Nelson opened the scoring that game. And a strong second half saw the Falcons win 3-1, so the Statesmen will hope to get revenge this time around before the Falcons end things a week from tomorrow against Auburn Montgomery. Despite senior night being on Sunday, it's the final time we've seen several Montevallo's Falcons. That's the end to a successful career at home for Elizabeth Blue, Taylor Gonzalez, Taylor Garrison, MJ Gray, Hampton Brinson, and Sarah Daniels. MJ Gray had a special occasion today, scoring her first goal in her final game at Varsity Field in the fifth minute. Simone Nelson had a hat trick, two in the first half and one to start the second half, before Emily Blue, Jada Johnson also got strikes that opened their account before Simone Nelson added a fourth. Put some gloss on the scoreline. 7-0 at the end of Varsity Field. Montevallo advanced to 8-5-1. Thank you for watching us all season. It's been another fantastic season of Montevallo women's soccer at Varsity Field. For the Falcon Athletic Network, for the final time, I'm Alex Tejada. 7-0 from Varsity Field. Montevallo taking down the Talladega College Tornadoes.